And that was a problem until I started to understand our history. History of the Reformed faith and our reformers like John Calvin, who spent almost as much of his time designing the sewer system and installing handrails and setting up the politics of Geneva as he did in preaching and writing theology. And then the day came when I became a pastor, and I was living in this community that felt very unloved by our church because we were sending all of our money to missionaries, and we weren't doing anything with our building. Our buildings were dilapidated, and our property looked awful, and these people said, "You must be all consumed for yourself," because they didn't see what we were doing overseas. They just looked locally, and they said, "You don't care about us. You only care about what's happening within the walls of your church." It was as we decided to spruce up things around our church that we got a hearing with our local neighbors, and then we started helping them physically and with mercy needs, and we started telling them about our faith, and then they listened to us. We had credibility. We started reaching our Jerusalem. Missionaries came back and they didn't say, "I can't believe you're spending all this time with your neighbors, and I can't believe you're spending all this time on your building." One missionary, who is a friend of this church too, came home and he said, "It's about time that you finally started doing what you tell us to do in the field." You know, when we come back from the field, you ask me in particular, how many people with tuberculosis have you cured, and how many have you won to Christ? But I never could ask you that because you don't do anything like that here. But now you do. They were encouraged. What we were doing locally gave credibility to what we were doing on the foreign field. And by addressing people's physical needs and even the needs of our local infrastructure, we had credibility both at home and abroad. So here's why we're here today. It is necessary for us to upfit and pay some attention to this local structure and local mission if we're going to be viable and sustainable for the long term.
Wow, it's hard to believe it's been a year, and what a full year it's been. From the slides you've just seen, we've accomplished much. A historic renovation and restoration of our sanctuary, the addition of an office building, upgrades and updates to children's, nursery, and adult classrooms, and the addition of technology that'll help us reach folks around the world through the internet. Much has been accomplished, but there's much more to be done. So I thank you for your support, for your patience, for your financial generosity as we seek to restore people and rebuild places, not just here, but around the world. Thank you.